Welcome all friends at the Dhamma. Mind the knower. The first session, I just let you learn to develop your heart. Okay? We call mindful awareness. Awareness, okay? This is the natural way of enlightenment. The Buddha said, trust and bliss and joy in your heart, okay? Then you can see things as they are, things inside your heart. Then you can let go and with understanding, it becomes dispassion. When you see it become dispassion, not attached, okay? But this session, because there are two ways of enlightenment, natural way and academic way. Most you practice in this day is academic way, okay? But this morning session, I just want to test. Even you don't know about any meditation practice, just mind and wake up, how you feel. Maybe you do much better than you do academic way. Academic way, you need to know about samatha, vipassana, or just start samatha to still your mind, okay? And vipassana to clear your heart. Samatha is calm down your mind. Vipassana is clean and clear your heart. First session, I can say that is vipassana. What is different between samatha and vipassana? Vipassana this morning, you see into the mental quality. That's right. You see inward. See inwards. Okay? But samatha, we watch or focus or put concentration forward. Okay? It different direction, okay? Okay. So, but somebody mind always good, nothing too much. Maybe can go natural way by smile and seeing smile, seeing your sensation, seeing into your smile, mental quality, okay? Or we can say, seeing by awareness. I just tell you, feel your pulse, and you feel your pulse again. Can you see your pulse or sensation? Feeling, whatever feeling, you see by awareness, okay? You don't have to look your eye with me, but your heart can awareness and see. And then I just tell you, awareness and see your sensation, then you can got awareness and see your heart and mental quality. When you turn inwards, then it become vipassana. Okay? But how to got seeing inside? I must explain how to see your sensation from your heart. Then you know, oh, just feeling or awareness first. Awareness, how you feel with your sensation. When you got awareness, and see. But this is awareness and see your pulse and sensation, how about to turn inwards, okay? When you got smile, you turn inward. And you more smile, this smile is more inwards, okay? This is seeing by awareness. What you practice vipassana, you must seeing by awareness. When you seeing by awareness, you can see even your so much movement, this is by awareness, okay? You can see your body movement, this is by awareness, okay? And I tell you, very simple, nobody can guess how to see by awareness, how? Selfie. Nobody can guess, selfie. You see by consciousness, okay? But this session, I will develop more samatha, the one-pointedness of mind. Okay? Because if you got good samatha, your mind still, then you got seeing more clearly. More still, more seeing clearly. So this session we will come to practice samatha or still your mind, calm down your mind, still your mind, and develop one pointedness in your mind. Okay? So just when I tell you to practice in your heart, this is here. But this session, practice in your mind. And when you understand both, then we can do together. Okay? We can practice both. Still your mind, be mindful, and good awareness. Okay? Your mind, okay? Monkey mind. Mindful, then calmness. Okay? When you got mindful, wake up, your heart wake up. Awareness. Okay? Awareness is come from inside your heart. When you can let go more and more, you wake up, more awareness. But more awareness will become more and more if you got good mindfulness, your mind become equanimous, not swaying, okay? Now your mind stirring with thought, okay? How? Just keep attention on my talk. Can you realize? Can you witness your mind? When your mind have attention, can you witness your attention in your mind when you keep attention on my talk? Your mind still, okay? So I want you to learn to develop yourself with your wisdom. How to develop wisdom? Witness what you got. When you start practicing meditation, you got calmness from the starting already. Okay? But you never witness. Okay? Now witness your mind. When you go to the airport and the traffic jam, what happened? Oh, a lot of thinking, missing the flight. Can you witness your mind? You don't have to look. You cannot look at your mind. Your mind very abstract. Okay? Just witness your mind. And when you arrive at the airport, can you witness your mind? Your mind calm down. And when you check in already, your mind joy. Okay? Can you witness your mind? Okay. And can you witness your mind when you check in already? And then, oh, plenty of time. Okay. Gate still not open. Okay. Your mind calm and don't worry, no thought. Can you witness your mind, no thought? Normally, you lost in thought. Today, I just tell you, witness your thought. Then it become less thought and calmness. But if you want to go into samatha or deep meditation, you must be able to learn to witness your mind, no thought. What different when you got thought, when you are in a traffic jam, and when you stay at the airport already, no thought. Can you witness no thought? Wow, very light. When you got thought, very heavy. Okay? Okay, can you witness your thought? Oh, very tense. Can you witness no thought? Very relaxed and very light. Okay, so witness your mind, and when your mind just relax, and then maybe you relax until the gate open, and then you not go to the gate, and then they just call your name, Mr. Mrs. Come to gate. Number 10 now. Can you witness your mind attention? Can you witness your mind attention when they call your name? Yeah, because you just relax and Facebook until you forget about gate. And then they say, Mr. come to gate now. Can you witness your mind attention? Okay. Now can you witness your mind when I speak loud? You maybe not have good attention. But if you hear or listen something quiet in this room, any voice, small voice, quiet voice in this room, can you just listen quiet voice in this room? What happened in your mind? My very still and very good attention. More quiet voice, more mindfulness. More quiet voice, more mindfulness. Any quiet voice doesn't matter, but everybody got the same, more mindfulness. Can you witness more mindfulness in your mind? Or good attention, more good attention in your mind? Now you can see your mind already. Mind will come and you can realize your mind when you got attention. Okay? You cannot see your mind by your eye. Okay? Because your mind got no shape, no form. Okay? But you can realize your mind. Because whenever your mind got good attention, you can realize and witness the stillness of mind, okay? So when you hearing quiet voice, listen to quiet voice, your mind more come back, really still, really still, and listen and hearing really quiet voice, more quiet voice, your mind more mindfulness. Now you can see your mind, mindfulness with good attention. So your mind is whenever you got attention. Okay? When you have no attention, your mind go somewhere else. Now keep attention on my word every moment. Can you see your mind? More attention. Witness. Can you witness your mind? Okay? So now I would like you to witness your mind. By your eye with me, but bring two finger up. When you can witness your mind, I would like you to learn how to watch from your mind. Now bring two finger up. Your eye doesn't look at the finger. Your eye with me. Can you watch from your mind the movement of the two finger? Watch the moment, not imagine, not visualize, not think about how your finger look like. Only watch the moment. Can you watch how you move slowly or fast? Can you? Your eye with me. But your mind work by intention and attention. When you got intention to know how you move your finger, your mind got attention. So operate your mind by intention to know. Then your mind become attention. Intention to know the movement of your finger. Now do it again. Your mind attention or not? So if you just keep attention on your finger movement, your mind watch the finger movement or not? Keep attention. Keep attention now. If you do it again, if you have purpose to move two finger to touch each other, witness your mind. When you have your goal to move two finger to touch each other, it become more attention or not? Can you witness more attention in your mind? Can you witness when it nearly touch, crossing together, it become more your mind really good attention, one pointedness, still not move, and touch, and it becomes one pointedness, okay? And when you move out, when you finish things successfully already, your mind become relaxed. Can you witness your mind become relaxed and let go? Can you witness? Because you do things successfully already, then you just, let go. Can you witness your mind let go? Yeah? And then when you start doing again, can you witness your mind when you start doing, you got attention. And when you got attention and you got intention to move, to touch each other, you have purpose in life, you have goal in life, your mind more good attention in doing things, more good attention, can you witness your mind more concentration from your mind? And when you nearly touch, your mind becomes still. Can you witness that is, I want you to go there, one-pointedness. Can you witness the one-pointedness when you nearly touch and touch your mind still? Can you witness your mind still and one point? And when you do successfully already, you become more relaxed again. Can you witness your mind more relaxed, more awareness? You can you witness more awareness when you, oh, great, then, ah. Can you witness more awareness, more relaxed in your mind? Ah, today, in this moment, I want you to learn stillness. Can you witness stillness in the mind? Mindfulness in the mind, awareness in the mind, calmness in the mind, one-pointedness in the mind, emptiness in the mind by this demonstration. Again, because this is, I would like to develop contemplation. Okay? Contemplation. How? Just witness. Witness, we're not involved. Okay? We're not involved. We just witness. Okay? Do it again. I would like to fulfill your wisdom, to be able to contemplate the four foundation, but now I just tell you to learn to witness your mind first. Now again, when you start doing, can you witness your mind? No thought. That's why. No thought about the past, the future, because you are doing something. Can you witness your mind here and now? No thinking about past and future. And when you doing with your goal alive, to touch this finger, to touch each other, your mind more concentration. Your eye don't have to look. Your mind more concentration. And when it nearly touching, your mind more attention, more one-pointedness, more one-pointedness. Can you witness one-pointedness and more mindfulness? Okay? And when touch or nearly touch, your mind still and one point. And when you move outwards, your mind become more awareness, relax. Can you witness awareness in your mind? With letting go, because you do already, then you let go. When you start doing again, can you witness mindfulness? You got mindfulness in your mind? Can you witness mindfulness in your mind? And more mindfulness when you got your intention to move two fingers to touch each other. Can you realize or witness more intention, more mindfulness, more attention? And can you witness your mind and it become still and one point? Can you witness your mind still and one point? Now, even you leave your hand, can you still witness your mind still and one point? Even you leave your hand? Or witness your mind very mindful, not lost. Or witness your mind good attention, because you just develop mindfulness, develop attention, develop stillness, it still got attention. That's right. But now, how to focus? Again, how to focus? Do it again, how to focus? How to focus from mind? You know how to focus from mind? Can you witness your mind if I tell you, keep good attention. Keep good attention on the finger movement. Your mind watching or not? Keep good attention on the finger movement with mindfulness, awareness. Can you witness your mind? Got mindfulness, awareness. And when you just tell your mind, good, keep good attention, your mind become good concentration. That's right. Not, it's different from when
Before you just put concentration from your thought, but today not from thought, from pure attention. Okay?
Again, keep good attention. Your eye don't have to look. But when you keep attention, can you keep attention? With relax, relax.
This is the right concentration. Okay?
Now, can you keep attention on your breathing? Even your eye open, but are you breathing or not? Can you keep attention on your breathing?
When you keep attention on your breathing, your eye now don't pay attention to me because your mind keep attention on your breathing. Then your mind watch.
Can you keep attention on every moment of the breathing in and out?
What difference? You put concentration.
You use your brain to force your mind. Okay? But I just tell you, keep good attention on your breathing. You not use your brain. Okay? You understand? Keep good attention. With your heart, good intention. Good intention to let go. So that's why this morning I teach you your heart first. Intention. Intention to wake up, to fly. Intention to wake up and know the present moment. Intention to wake up, how? Put two wings. When you have intention to wake up for what? Keep attention on your breathing in when you wake up. Wake up first, okay? When you wake up first, you got pure mindfulness, attention, notice and watch. Watch and notice every moment. The breathing in, the breathing out. And close your eye. Keep attention with good intention. I will know my breathing only and let go all in the past and the future. Let go all thought and worry, everything. I will know my breathing with good attention. This is how to got right concentration. Your mind just work by your intention and attention, not work by your thought, desire, I put concentration. No I, only mindfulness. Just intention, attention with mind, with joy. When you have intention and attention on whatever, if you have joy, then you can stay there for constantly, okay? Intention and attention on your breathing with joy. Because whenever you come back to your breathing, you become peaceful. That's why you got joy every time when you come back to your breathing, okay? You got joy every time, then intention and attention, and put two wings. So then you got foundation of your heart. Foundation of your heart, that is consciousness. Before you don't have consciousness, you only use your thought to focus, okay? Now, with joy and I will, intention by I will let go everything and know my breathing only, every moment, can you? Tell your heart. When you tell your heart, then your heart will operate your mind. Okay? Tell your heart, I will let go all everything and will know the present moment on the breathing only. Then your heart will operate your mind. And tell your heart, just joy in the practice. Joy in the practice, good operation. Okay?
Joy in the practice or enjoy your heart must enjoy your breathing, knowing your breathing with joy and bliss. Now your heart got joy and bliss, then your mind very mindful, not tense, okay? Very pure attention. And cross your eye for 5 minutes, but don't forget to wink. And don't forget joy in your heart. Wake up and smile in your heart. Your heart will operate your mind. When your heart wake up, just put intention in your heart. I will stay with my breathing, in and out, knowing, seeing, watching, only. Wash from your mind, not wash from your brain. Wash and notice from your mind. When you wash and notice together, it's more constant mindfulness. And with awareness, how? Smile. You got foundation. Smile, you got big antenna dish, more big antenna dish. Your mindfulness very sharp. Right concentration is just keep attention in your heart, in your mind. I will watch and notice my breathing every moment and not expect anything and let go of past and the future. You have right intention this way, your mind more good attention. And you got two wings to wake up, then you have no self in the practice. Just intention, attention on your breathing. Keep good attention by good intention on your breathing together. Attention. And witness your mind, attention together. It become good attention, witness. Attention, when you practice attention, you got attention from the beginning or not? Witness. When you have attention, you have mindfulness. More mindfulness, more calmness. More mindfulness, more meditation. Meditation is from your continuous mindfulness every moment. Calmness is the result of your good mindfulness every moment. and smile in your heart, you got awareness of feeling your breathing together. Feeling from your heart awareness and watch from your mind, mindfulness. Feeling from your heart awareness and watch from your mind, mindfulness. Feeling your breathing and watch. Feeling your breathing in and watch. Feeling your breathing out and watch. Good mindfulness, you need awareness or feeling together. If you only watch and without awareness, it becomes tense. Relax and smile in your heart and feel your breathing and watch. Feel your breathing in and watch. Feel your breathing out and watch. Feel your breathing in and watch. And if you feel your breathing in and watch, feeling you can feel in between, breathing in and out, got a pause for 1 or 2 seconds. Can you feel the breathing and the pause? Then you can watch the breathing and in between, got a pause. Watch the breathing in and the pause inside before breathing out. And then watch the breathing out and let go. Breathing out, let go. Breathing in, go to the pause. You got a pause inside because you got spreading oxygen throughout the whole body. In about 1 or 2 seconds, you can realize the pause in between breathing in and out. If you feel your breathing, you can feel the pause. Then you feel your breathing, you watch your breathing. You feel the pause, you watch the pause. Feel your breathing out, but when you're breathing out, you need oxygen immediately. Don't worry about the pause outside. Just let go, and then breathing in naturally, you need oxygen. But when breathing in, before breathing out, it got a pause. Can you realize the pause? When you can realize the pause, then you can watch every moment, breathing in and the pause. Breathing out, then let go. Breathing in and the pause. And just put 2 wings. On your shoulder to help you wake up. Then you're not involved. And smile. Then you can realize the natural breathing in and pause. Breathing out and let go because you need oxygen immediately. Breathing in and watch the breathing in and pause. And slowly open your eye. I will show you something. Now this is your hand. Bring your right hand up. Don't look by your eye, but feel by your heart. Can you feel the movement by your heart? When you feel the movement more and more from heart, your mind will attention. That's right. Your mind become watching. That's right. Can you feel the movement and watch? Can you feel the movement and watch? More feeling, more relax. Okay? If you watch only, then you become tense. Okay? So feeling first, awareness first. Feeling and watch. Can you feel the movement and watch? Witness what you got in your mind when you feel the movement and watch. What you got? Calmness. How about now? Just follow me. Movement and stop. Can you realize the stop? Your mind become one pointedness. Can you witness your mind become stop? When you witness the stop, when you watch the stop, your mind stop. When you watch the movement, your mind become awareness, mindfulness. But when you watch the stop, your mind become meditation. When you watch the movement, your mind become mindfulness, awareness. And you watch the stop, your mind become good meditation. Okay? So, just by your mind, watch the movement and stop. Your mind stop. When your mind watch the stop, your mind stop thinking completely and really, really still. Okay? And when you watch the movement, your mind still got a bit thought, okay? But when you watch the stop, your mind stop thinking completely, that's right? So witness your mind, when you watch the movement of the hand, your mind got a bit thought, but when you watch the stop, your mind stop thinking completely. But when you watch the movement, you got a bit thought, but you still good, you have mindfulness and awareness. But when you watch the stop, your mind stop thinking completely, okay? And more stop. Can you witness movement stop, movement stop, movement stop, movement stop, movement stop, movement stop, movement stop? You mind more stop, 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 stop. Okay? Now even the hand movement, your mind stop already. Okay? So again, more stop. Moment stop, moment stop. Watch the moment stop, moment stop. How to watch, feel, feeling and watch, 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 feeling and watch. But in the beginning, only generally first. Moment stop, moment stop, moment stop. Just not rush, only generally first, okay? Can you witness what happened? What different when you watch the breath, watch the movement of the hand, and when you watch the stop? What quality you got in your mind? When you watch the movement, you got mindfulness, awareness. But when you watch the stop, you got good meditation, okay, or stillness, okay? Can you witness? Witness your mind. And now, you are breathing. Got stop inside or not? Breathing deeply. It got stop 2 seconds or 1 second, 2 seconds and come out. That's right. But when it breathing out, don't try to stop breathing out. You need oxygen immediately. Okay? Breathing out, let go. Okay? Breathing is the technique to bring your consciousness calm, 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 calm to where? Calm to your heart. Stop is in your heart. More stop, your heart wake up. More stop, your heart wake up. Okay? It's the technique to bring your mind from thought. Come to your breathing consciousness and come to the stop. More stop, your heart more relaxed and open. Okay? But when breathing out, don't have to concentrate the breathing out. Just concentrate the breathing in, because we use breathing in to bring your mind calm in. Okay? Breathing out, just awareness. Okay? Breathing in, more concentration.
breathing out, let go. Okay? Because you know, go into the nature of mind, you must, it look like in the nature of mind inside, very deep, there is many layer. You must go slowly and let go. Then why I tell you, more let go, you go to the next room, okay? And let go, and then go inside. If you only try to focus, you cannot go deep into your mind, okay? You need watch and let go, okay? Watch and let go. Okay, try now. How to watch? Again, how to watch? Your eye cannot look in your mouth, but can you watch chewing, eating in your mouth? Can you watch? Where you watch? Not by eye. Where you watch? From the one inside your mind. Can you witness? If I tell you, watch every moment on the touching. Can you witness? Your mind very, very sharp, mindfulness. And if I tell you, watch the fire element, your eye cannot look at the fire element in your mouth, but can you watch warm? Fire element is warm or hot in your mouth. Can you watch? When you watch from your mind, you got calmness from the beginning. But if you watch from your brain, where fire element? Where? How it look like? You cannot get calmness. Okay? Can you watch the water element in your mouth? Can you watch? Can you watch air element in your mouth? Can you watch earth element in your mouth? In the harness. So, just I give you technique. Watch four element, or even only five element is enough. When you watch warm in your mouth, calmness comes immediately. You got instant calmness in 3 seconds because your mind become very good mindfulness instantly. Okay? Can you watch fire element warm or hot in your mouth? You stop thinking and you go inside. That's why. Can you watch? If somebody cannot, have you been to the dentist? Now the dentist cleaning your teeth. Your mind wash and not think about family, washing here only. Can you witness your mind washing? Can you witness the one who wash? And if the dentist say, this one you need to take out, and then the dentist taking out, you not completely stop thinking and wash carefully. Can you witness your mind is the knower? This is the object of knowing. When this is very pain, your mind see pain, your mind let go and go back. But that's why the Buddha say, see suffering, then you can see the way to the end of suffering. Because when you see suffering, you let go, you go back. But when you see happiness, you got okay? When you got happiness, you not see yourself, you not see your mind. But when you got suffering, now I take the dentist, take your tooth out. This is suffering. Can you see your mind? Your mind separate from the object. You can see? This is, we call the mind the knower. See the knower. know the knower. That is the way to the one pointedness of mind, still mindful and with understanding. So can you stay still in your mind and know what you sit on your cushion, soft or hard? Can you know in your mind not move? You can move your seat. Can you know awareness? Can you witness awareness in your mind? Okay, your mind, even this is got a distance. Okay. Before you don't know, I tell you. If I not tell you, you just try to put your mind on the cushion. But now you just know, this is object. The knower stay at home. Even object is on the cushion, the knower at home is very good, clear knowing. You just stay at home and just keep attention on your cushions, on your seat. You got awareness, how soft or hard. If you not got awareness, I put something very, very sharp on your cushion. Oh, master, oh, very sharp. Okay? You go back. You stay at home, okay? So there are principles. What you watch is the object. The breathing is the object. And can you witness the knower? The knower always lost with the object. It looks like when this is object, and then you say, concentration. I cannot see what time. But if I just go back to the knower, I can see 10:25. I can see clearly. If you watch, you need a distance or a gap. Knower always free from whatever you look. Okay? Then you can see clearly. But today you watch very close. And the knower got stuck. Don't know how to go further. But if the knower wake up, breathing here, the knower, this is feeling. This is object, feeling of your breathing. But this is knowing feeling. Knowing feeling at home. Feeling can be anywhere. Can you feel your right shoulder? Can you know at home? Can you know at home? Can you watch at home? Can you see at home? If you can watch at home, see at home, you can witness the knower clearly also, okay? See the knower, know the knower together if you know at home. Can you feel your neck behind? Can you feel? And how about, can you know your feeling on your neck? What difference? Feeling on your neck is here, on your neck. Knowing your feeling is in your mind. That's right. Can you know your feeling here? How about more distant? Can you know your feeling on your seat? Now, very clear, because it got more distant. Then you can see that knower is in your mind. No need to move, okay? No need to go out. Even you feel on the body, any part, okay? That is feeling, okay? But the knower is here, okay? Knower. If you stay knowing, okay? Stay at knowing and knowing. You can know your movement, can you? Can you know your smile, can you? Can you know your breathing in? Can you know your breathing out, can you? Knowing and knowing. But this is object. Object, and who is the knowing? Knowing at home, okay? When you know at home, then you can know everything. That means know the body, know sensation, know your mind quality. That's right. Okay? Knowing and knowing. Now, just stay knowing and knowing. When you knowing and knowing, it's more stable, not move. Knowing doesn't have to move, but your body can move. Knowing is your mind. Mind is knowing. Okay? But before, your knowing move. Because your knowing become self. I want to calm down your mind. I want to focus the breathing. You are knowing move out. Okay? Okay? So you have wrong concentration. Right concentration, you must see both. Both, that is object and the knower. Can you see me and see how you think? Can you witness how you think together? Can you witness your mind, your heart? Okay? Your mind, your heart at home. Because I'm a monk. If I'm a handsome man, maybe your mind come to me. Ah! I'm a monk, no problem. Okay? Okay, now stay at home. There are five channels, five sensory organs. Look, but can you stay at home? Here, knowing at home, there are five doors. Eye channel, ear channel, nose channel, tongue channel, body channel. If you stay at home, your mind become equanimous. Okay? If you stay at home, anything pass, can you see anything? Or who sitting, who walking? You don't have to look. So today, I just tell you, always you look, just come back to watch. When you look, you go out. Okay? Can you come back to watch? Now, look and watch together. Whenever when you look and you watch, you got mindfulness. Okay? And whenever you look, you watch, you got good meditation. Where is meditation? In daily life, you look at your job. If you not watch your job, you don't have meditation. If you look your job, at your job, you watch your job, you got meditation because your mind is at the present moment. Okay? Look and watch. Now can you look at the Buddha image, statue? Can you watch the Buddha face, the Buddha ear, the Buddha nose? You got good meditation, okay? Sometimes you look at me because you open your eye already. But really, sometimes you think about something else, you not watch me, okay? You told me, I will look at my breathing, you will look at your breathing. But actually inside you not watch your breathing, you fall asleep. Okay? So, look and watch is meditation. Watch and see clearly is vipassana. Okay? Look and watch. Now look and watch again. Can you look and watch in your mouth again? Oh, don't have to look. Your mouth inside you can watch. When you look object outside, then you have to watch, connect. But when you watch yourself, you don't have to use your eye. Can you watch yourself how you sit? By your mind. Okay? How you move, look and watch. Ah, I show you. Now, I will light the incense stick. Just demonstrate to you. I can witness my mind watch. My eye look, my mind watch. This is meditation. Okay? Now you got your finger. This is candle, this is incense stick. Now try. Just light the incense stick with this finger. Close, and light the incense stick. Can you witness your mind watch? Can you witness your mind watching? If you witness your mind become one pointedness. Attention. Can you witness your mind attention? Can you? If you can witness your mind, you already get into meditation when you witness your mind. But you never witness your mind. You watch your breathing. You never witness your mind. You fall asleep. Now watch your breathing. But witness your mind.
or the one who watch your breathing. Can you witness your mind inside? Watch your breathing in. Watch your breathing out. Your mind watching or not? But you witness more and more. Your mind got more mindfulness because you got seeing. Seeing by your wisdom, not seeing by eye. Can you see by your wisdom, by your understanding, by your awareness, your mind attention on your breathing or not? See your mind watch your breathing, but see your mind, witness your mind. Really, your mind watch your breathing or not? Or your mind maybe traveling somewhere else? And can you witness your mind? You might sometimes traveling somewhere else. When you witness, it come back. Okay? When you witness, it come back. Okay? So now, if you be able to witness your mind, even it go out, become thought, then it come back really quickly. Okay? That's right? So now, one more example. Can you witness your mind? If this is a gun, long gun, you shooting, put your arm like a gun and long gun and shooting, not shooting me, shooting on this flower, or this flower. Can you shooting now? Shooting, aim, put on your arm, aim. Can you witness your mind? Wake up, still and aim. Can you witness the gunman? Aim. Can you witness the gunner? Can you witness? That is the knower. I use the word, the gunman. Can you witness the gunman when you aim? Okay? Can you witness your mind? If I give you diamond, now I give you diamond. What difference if I give you diamond and stone? Now I give you diamond first. And you watch the diamond. Everybody just pretend to watch the diamond now. If it's diamond, then you wash or not? Wash. Wash the color, wash the calibration, wash the quality, and see the price. You got wash. Wash the color, wash calibration, wash the quality, and see the price. Okay? But if I give you stone, you not wash. Your mind not wash. But if I give you now 2 carat, 3 carat diamond, very small, can you witness your mind? That is meditation. So next time practice meditation, bring diamond with you. better. Because everybody like diamond. Okay, you got joy when you got joy and happiness when you see diamond. And then your mind still. Can you witness your mind still? Then you just leave diamond and then go inside. Stay there. Okay? Really good technique. Okay? Okay, now just can you watch your chanting? Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. If you know your mind, the knower, now I want you to watch near to your mind. What is near you to your mind? Your thought. Okay, what you think? Can you realize the one who always lost in thought? Okay? Can you see your thought? If you can see your thought, then you can witness the one. The one is the knower. The knower seeing thought. Thought is object. When knower seeing thought cannot overcome the knower. Thought going away by itself when you can see thought. When you not see thought, mind go inside and overcome by thought. When you can see thought, mind the knower wake up and see thought, and thought go away. Okay? But now, before you can let go thought, you must sharpen your mind more and more. Now you don't lost in thought, but can you chanting? Chanting, there is rhythm, Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. Can you witness your mind who watch the chanting Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. There is a rhythm, Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. Buddha, stop. Movement, stop. Movement, stop. Okay? Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. Can you see chanting? Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. Sangho, Dhammo, Buddha. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. And witness. Witness. Witness that is the one who know Buddha. How to witness the one who know Buddha? Buddha with the rhythm. Buddha, stop. Dhammo, Sangho. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. Sangho, Dhammo, Buddha. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. You know, your mind never train to see your chanting. Your mind always lost with your chanting, fly to the object. But when I tell you, there is rhythm, there is pause in between chanting. Buddha, you got a bit pause. Can you see pause? Then you might wake up. Okay? Can you see pause? Buddha. When you not see pause, Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho, Sangho, Dhammo, Buddha. The never lost. Okay? When you can see pause, Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. Now you can see chanting is an object. But you can rely, there is a knower who knows the chanting. When you can rely the rhythm of pause. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho, Sangho, Dhammo, Buddha. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho, Sangho, Dhammo, Buddha. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho, Sangho, Dhammo, Buddha. Okay? Even fast, there is a rhythm or stop. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. So today, we will make skillful means to see near your mind. Okay? If you can see your near your mind, then you can see mental quality in your mind. Okay? But today, we see near our mind the chanting. Okay? You think about Buddha, but can you just see there is rhythm. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. Sangho, Dhammo, Buddha. When you see the rhythm, movement stop, movement stop, movement stop. Can you witness your mind? More still, more stop, more still, more stop. Then you go into meditation in 1 minute only. Okay? Now, this session, just Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho, and put your two wings. Okay? Wake up. Two wings, right? Your shoulder open and you are ready to fly. That means you are ready to wake up. Wake up your heart first by sitting straight up and put your two wings, your shoulder wake up. Okay? And then when your shoulder wake up, your consciousness wake up. When you chanting Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho, then more consciousness wake up. More consciousness wake up. Only chanting Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho and put your shoulder like eagle wing, okay? But this is technique, okay? Don't try to imagine eagle wing all the time. Just only put and let go, okay? Put and let go, okay? When you wake up, then let go, okay? And then are you ready to fly? Flying with Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho, quiet. By yourself. No voice, just in your mind. Can you see chanting? Yeah, if you wake up, you can see chanting. And can you witness your mind? Your mind wake up, more awareness, more awareness of chanting. Your mind become emptiness. Can you witness calmness, emptiness in your mind? Mind is calmness. Mind is emptiness. Mind is thought. Mind, thought, more thought, less thought is mind. Calmness is mind. How to witness your mind? If your mind become thought, just witness thought. Okay? Thought is mind. When you witness thought, thought become less thought. Less thought is mind. When you witness less thought become no thought. No thought is mind. No thought is calmness. You can witness calmness. That is, you can see your mind. Okay? And more seeing calmness, calmness more and more become emptiness. When you just chanting and you got knowing every moment, knowing Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho, knowing only Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. Your mind emptiness of the past and the future, but what not empty is knowing, clear knowing the present moment of your chanting. And witness your mind. When God knowing your chanting, your mind become more clear awareness. And if you smile in your heart together, your mind become more consciousness, more bright. Okay? The darkness in your mind gone, the light come in your mind. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. Sangho Dhammo Buddho Buddho Dhammo Sangho. Face up, straight up your body. And how to straight up your body? Just feeling you got two wings, eagle wing, ready to fly. Then your body straight up and let go, not imagine. When wake up already, let go and come awareness, mindfulness of your chanting every moment with knowing, seeing, chanting, and knowing, seeing the one who chanting. Knowing the mind who chanting, seeing the mind who chanting, we call knowing the knower together, seeing the knower together. You know the chanting before, but you don't know the knower. Today you know the chanting, you know the knower together. You see the chanting before, you don't see the knower. Today you see the chanting, you must see the knower together. And smile. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho, Sangho, Dhammo, Buddha. Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho. Sangho Dhammo Buddho. And smile. And know the knower together with the chanting. See the knower together with the chanting. That's all. Then it open up to pureness, emptiness and pureness inside. Your mind originally pure, clear and emptiness. But you lost in thought. Today you're not lost in thought. Know the chanting, know your mind. See the chanting, see your mind. Know the chanting, know your mind. See the chanting, see your mind. By just knowing and seeing the rhythm of the chanting. Buddha and stop. Dhammo, Sangho, Sangho, Dhammo, Buddha, Buddha, Dhammo, Sangho, Sangho, Dhammo, Buddha. There is a pause between each chanting, okay? Can you see the pause in between each chanting? Then you can see your mind. And in your heart, smile with trust in the Buddha. You will got good foundation from your heart. Good foundation will be the power for your mind to be more awareness, to be more mindfulness.
Buddho Dhammo Sangho Sangho Dhammo Buddho Buddho Dhammo Sangho Sangho Dhammo Buddho. If you use chanting for object of meditation, don't worry about the breathing. Only chanting, only. See the chanting, know the chanting, know the rhythm in between. When you come to your mind, smile and see your mind, see your good mind, see your beautiful mind by selfie, 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 selfie. Selfie in your mind more opening up. Selfie more, your mind more opening up. Selfie more, your mind more opening up to emptiness. Chanting and selfie, chanting and selfie, your mind, the knower. Selfie and selfie, the knower. Chanting and selfie, the knower. Chanting and selfie, the knower. Buddho, Dhammo, Sangho, and selfie, the knower. Sangho, Dhammo, Buddho, Buddho, Dhammo, Sangho, Sangho, Dhammo, Buddho. Dhammo Sangho, Sangho Dhammo Buddho. Smile and selfie your mind. Smile in your mind. Smile in your mind and selfie. Smile and selfie. Chanting and selfie. Smile with smile. Chanting and selfie with smile. Chanting and selfie with smile. And wake up inside with two wings on your arm, ready to fly in emptiness, ready to wake up in emptiness. Knowing and knowing, knowing and knowing, chanting move, knowing not move, knowing and knowing, knowing not knowing, knowing, chanting move, putto, dhammo, sangho, but knowing not move, knowing is knowing not move, then it not move, when not move, it become clear knowing, clear knowing, clear knowing, and emptiness. And before we finish this session, just review what you learned today by absorption. Absorption the calmness. Absorption of the emptiness. Absorption of your mindfulness, awareness, beautiful calmness. Learn it, understanding it, until it becomes your property. Your good quality in your mind. And every time we finish, just transfer merit by keep your two hands open, your knee. And with my transfer merit with my to everybody here and now, everybody in Australia and all beings in the world. How much you got happiness, let all beings getting more and more happiness. And just now, smile to yourself. You bring back your merit back to yourself for your good luck, good health, good life, happiness, and all success. And just now, slowly
moving yourself and opening your eye. And we finish this session. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.